Good morning, welcome to the Toddcast. Today, me and Adam are hauling some rock. So Adam has taken us into the 21st century.
Yep.
22nd, something like that. This is mind-blowing to this hillbilly. Now we're going to see how well that thing holds up in a single axle dump truck bouncing down the road.
That'll be a real test.
I just arrived at our next job. I couldn't remember exactly which size pipe we had measured for this job. We think it's 18. We're going to crawl down in here and just double check before we haul the excavator and the pipe up here. This is going to be our access, our wonderful access. Down in there is where we've got to work, amongst all of the, can you tell if that's kudzu or poison ivy?
It is not. Wait, this one?
Yeah, the three leaf.
It looks too smooth to be poison ivy, yep. But correct.
Yeah, poison ivy doesn't have this little notch.
Yeah.
It's a lot smaller. So that's our pipe that we got to measure down in there. And this is, we gotta fill all of this in. So the only digging we've got to do, that's our gas line. Only digging, I think we're gonna bring a 45 out of there and come out through here. And then 45 again to go out straight. This whole backyard tends to flood when it rains. This is a little soft in here right now. That's the project at hand.
Should be fun.
Couple of days, I think, tops. We already had 811 come and mark everything, so we know what's up. Let's measure that pipe. Adam's got a application on his telephone with which he's going to measure this. Looks like there's a lot of greenery along this, but really, it's not that thick. I may not even strip it. Is it 18? Nice. So, 18 it is.
Yep.
And those other two pipes, they're the 10s, right?
You want me to measure them?
Yeah, might as well. Just to double check before we haul a bunch of stuff out here. I'll have to get that little app. Location 2.
You've actually got the one I'm using right now.
Oh, I do?
Yep, it comes on the iPhone.
Oh. Cool.
Yep, it's 10.
Alright. So I need the 110.
You need me to measure the other one?
Yeah, if you want to. Here's the rain has moved in, Adam.
Yes, it has. It's very gray.
I think it'd be a bad idea to dig into the ground at this point.
Probably wouldn't be our best move.
Calling for a lot of rain tomorrow. So we are going to go practice Adam's backing for his CDL test and answer all of the questions for all of you folks out there who are asking why is he double clutching? It doesn't do anything. It does do something. And he did call today and confirm that during his CDL test, he is required to double clutch. So, for all you Nancys out there, he has to double clutch. And it'd be wise to double clutch and get good at it before he tests. After he tests, he's more than welcome to float the gears. So there's your answer. Why he double clutches. Alright, we have Adam's cone set up. The picture that I looked up said that there was to be 12 feet between those cones.
How you feeling, Adam?
I think your measuring stick's off. There's no way it's supposed to be this narrow.
You'd be really good at backing by the time you do this.
I guarantee I run every one of them over.
Well, that would be par for the course for all of us.
Yep.
Well, you want me to try it first?
I am curious to see if you can do it. Let's see if old Trucker Todd can still pass his road test. This is going to be great. Be doggone, he's gonna do it. If we can get the Big Mac swung around. Is he gonna clear it? No. Is that allowed? Nope, not yet. And then there it is. First try. Yeah. Are you allowed to pull up like that?
Yep. You can't have excessive pull-ups. The school I went to allowed three.
Yeah. I don't know, I ran into a car. There's supposed to be a box, like here or here. I know it's 40 feet you're supposed to measure off from this cone to that.
So I think I was close.
If my box, my 2 foot box, I think it's 2 feet, was back here, we'd be good. If it's here, I screwed up. I was aiming to put my bumper in here.
I got a little careless. A little overconfident.
Somewhere there's a smart car that just got crashed. But how do we do on this side? Ooh, I failed.
That's failure? Yep, you'd have run that over.
Yeah, I went right over top. Well, I'm right on. Yeah, I think I'm over.
I think so.
So what I would say, Adam, you pull straight out, don't run the cones over, loop around that way, set up, and you can't cheat now. You got to go in a straight line across through there. Not that I would think you would cheat, ever.
Okie doke.
You're going to be awesome.
Oh, this is going to be epic, for sure.
I'm pretty excited about just not, I don't know how I didn't move that cone.
You must,
I definitely failed, though. I think that's a failure.
It's not bad, considering. How long has it been since you've tried to do this?
16 years. 15, 16. Of course, I have to back it on a daily basis.
But I'm telling you, those parking spots are wider than this. This is total malarkey.
Well, let's see how you do, pal.
I'm sure it'll be great.
I will just say, it's easier to turn out sooner than too late. Yep. I'm gonna really enjoy this. Yeah, I would just loop around that way. And just go way out through there and loop around.
How much one better I take out a cone on the way out?
I will catch it on film.
Perfect.
I can assure you, I won't miss it.
I believe it.
Watch Adam work his magic. This is CDL week. We're gonna really press back, and we're gonna try to back every single day in multiple different ways. We've got to do, this is a dock back, so he's got to pull out, swing out, and then back into it, at, starting from like a 45 degree angle. See, he thought he was gonna take cones out. He's a better driver than he thinks. We'll watch him try a couple. You gotta enjoy your job. This is Adam's first time doing a dock backing practice. I got you in low reduction too. Yeah. He's setting up proper. And I'm just not gonna say anything to him. We did just a little bit of practice at the truck stop backing into a spot the other day. That was a good setup. He continued forward just a little too far. We'll document this one, let him run through a few. Uh-oh. Oh, boy. I love my job. There may be some instruction involved with this one. Good news is he's been driving for 6 weeks with me. I don't know, let's see. Well, I know 3 or 4 weeks, and he hasn't absolutely just run anything over other than cracking one mirror, so I call that a win. There's his first experience. I ended up having him do one pull up a little way, and I just talked him into the spot. He didn't have to pull up again. He did really well with instruction. I gave him some pointers on how far to turn out, how far to pull up, how to position the truck and trailer, and now he's going to do it on his own. See how he does. Once you make that initial turn outward,
yep,
just keep going straight and let the truck pull the trailer straight in line with you. You got it. This is not as easy as it looks, folks. And it just takes practice.
Did I kill the cone?
You killed the cone!
Dang it.
Set your brakes so I can show you. What's happening is that your truck is so long,
uh-huh,
and your trailer is really, the distance between your pedal hitch and your rear axle
is actually almost shorter than the distance between your rear axle and your steer axle. Therefore, at the point you wanted that trailer to start turning is actually 10 feet before you just thought it. It takes 10 feet of movement and a change in direction of your wheel for that trailer to react.
I'd have guessed that.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is definitely not the proper angle. Uh-oh. I broke it.
Earl died. He killed Earl.
I really didn't expect it to crack.
You didn't do that. That's been cut.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it was like that when I put it out first time.
Well, that's defective. We should return that.
Yes. So, it takes, you know, like, when I'm back in a trailer, what I'm imagining is if I'm standing up here holding on to the pintle hitch, walking the trailer in. Like if I'm just standing there holding that ring. So, you got to think about, what do I have to do with this truck to move that ring? And it takes about 10 feet of movement of that truck before that ring will start to move. You're no longer in a Class C world.
Should I be able to see that cone at
no,
all?
No, okay. No. Every point of reference after you set up is over here. You might be able to see that cone, but you just got to learn in your head that you only have 12 feet between those two cones. So as soon as you are more than, you know, this far, you know, it might be only 2 feet here, but it's a whole lot longer when you get to the corner of your trailer. So,
yep.
Your trailer should be getting straight with this aisle lane by the time you get to here.
I agree.
Yep. So your trailer should be in line. Otherwise, the only way, if you get to here and your trailer is not straight, you've got to be at a 45 degree angle. Your truck has to be at a 45 degree angle with the trailer, because that's the only way that you can push that front end of the trailer around without it driving the trailer forward. As soon as you start swinging the front of the truck around, that trailer starts traveling. It's piece of cake, really.
Third time's.
This is good use of a rainy day. We couldn't dig into the ground, so we might as well practice, right? This is a tough test and something to learn with a regular tractor trailer, let alone pulling a little short trailer like that with a tri-axle, a dump truck. It is not easy. And I failed him. I meant to tell him to turn his four ways on every time he's backing up. There. Oh, so close.
Is that a fail?
That's a fail.
Dang it. So close.
At least it wasn't Earl this time. Let's see here. Well, you didn't jackknife, that's a plus.
I did?
You did not.
Oh. Am I close to jackknifing?
Pretty close. Pretty close.
I think I'm getting it.
Well, you didn't go too far that time.
Exactly. Progress.
Narrowing it down, my friend.
Exactly.
Let's try her again. Actually, I think I hit it right on the line. Third time's a charm. Maybe. No telling how many times it's going to take to get to where he nails it every time They will. He'll get there. Oh, that's a nice one. That was a nice one. Real nice. Everybody start chasing it. I'm just gonna get you hop out so I can show you what to do at this point.
Oh, now man,
you nailed it, man.
Man, I know exactly what to do. The pro.
What you gonna do?
I'm gonna pull up. I've yet to decide which direction, but I will pull up so that I now can get the macro in here. Mac's not going in at this rate.
All right, now are you going to turn your wheels to the right, then pull up, turn them to the left, pull up, or straight and pull up?
Well, my instinct would be to turn them to the right and pull up, but I feel that you would tell me that's the wrong answer.
In order to do a consistent, you know, repair of the situation that you've gone a little too far with your tires,
yep.
What I would do is just straighten, pull straight forward until you get your angle lined up with the truck to where once you pull straight forward, you pretty well know that you hard left and it'll fall right into place.
I got this.
I think you do too. I think you got it.
All day.
Just don't screw it up or 28,000 people are going to see it.
That's all right. There ain't no shame in my game.
Truth be told, he could cut a hard right, but when learning, it's best to do straight maneuvers with the truck. That's the way I was taught, anyway, and it made it really easy for me. Oh yeah, that's perfect. Now all he's got to do is hard left and chase it in. Keep it hard left. He may pull a tide here in a second. Ooh, that's gonna be close. That's gonna be close. Well, he didn't go out of the box. And if this was a 2-foot square for the bumper to go into, he would have stopped just shy, but he's in the box. I think that'd be good. Nailed it!
What?
Nailed it!
I'm a boss.
The only thing I'm in question of is I don't know how big this box is, whether it's a 2, 3, or 5-foot box that you gotta stop the bumper in. We'll have to look that up.
So but now, is this a failure? Because I'm definitely not in line over here anymore.
But you didn't go out.
I stopped. Like,
you are right on the line, but I don't think as far as going out of the box, you didn't. I would be happy with that if I were you.
So are you saying that when they put these cones out, it's going to be like a cone to a box, and that's like my little area?
Yeah, there's going to be 8 cones up through there, but there's going to be a box drawn on the ground back here that you got to stop the bumper in.
This bad boy?
Yeah, the very back of the trailer.
Now, would they consider this the very back of the trailer?
I would. Anyway, the farthest protruding thing is what I would go by, because that's what's going to hit stuff.
That's valid.
Yep. I would feel pretty good about it if I were you.
I'm basically a super trucker at this point.
Yes. Yes. Now do it perfectly for the next 10 times.
Yeah. We'll see.
All right, Adam, how was your experience with the backing over cones?
And like I said, I'm basically a super trucker now.
I think you're about ready.
I only ran over, what, 1? 2 maybe? 2, I think.
I think, like, actually running them over, yeah, twice. That's not bad.
It's better than I've done at most things.
That's not bad. I think you're ready to test. What do you think?
I think I should probably practice a few more backwards maneuvers.
Yeah.
But, and learn the pre-trip.
Yeah.
But, I think pre-trip's gonna be the, biggest time suck we have left.
Yeah, you got the gist of it anyway, so we'll just go through specific. So that was your 90 degree or dock side backing. We've got to do like a serpentine type
back. Straight line backing. If you can 90 degree, you can straight line.
I should hope so.
Then we'll nail it down. What do you think? 2 weeks?
I don't think I can learn the pre-trip that quick. I think I can learn how to back that quick.
I think about months.
Yeah?
About months, yeah. Off and on training.
That, and I got to quit losing my gears.
Excuse me.
Because since I do know that I do, in fact, have to double clutch, I don't know how they'll feel about me finding gears without the clutch.
Mystery.
Yes.
We'll nail it down. I'd say about a month you'll have it down.
Cool.
Yep. Yes, indeed. Then we will take over the world.
One step at a time.
Yep. You guys, thanks for joining us on yet another daily adventure. We will be back maybe day after tomorrow. It's supposed to pour all day tomorrow. We'll just do some quotes, boring stuff. But we will be back. We love you guys, and we will see you on the next one.